Good morning, everyone. My name is Mujtaba-Tasneem, and this is my partner, Deccan. We are from Deccan Medical College, we are inculcating. We are presenting a case of Calcaneo Valgus ligamentous plasticity corrected by bilateral gradual osmosis. Introduction. Pes planovalgus deformity present with disruption of hind foot alignment towards the valgus, disappearance of longitudinal axis of the feet, and improvement of impairment of plantigrade walking. It is mostly encountered due to muscle imbalance arising from the spastic rise of pubis and meridional muscle, and is commonly seen in patients with cerebral palsy or because of unforced action of crucifixes and avertors of foot. Various causes for calcaneo valgus feet are poliomyelitis, cerebral palsy, meningomyelitis, ligamentous plasticity, etc. After eradication of poliomyelitis, the prevalence of deformity and need of surgery has been decreased drastically, and it is not a commonly done procedure in orthopedics. Along with the growth period, the progression of deformity cannot be stopped by conservative intervention because of persisting muscle imbalance. Prior to development of permanent contraction and structural process changes, surgical options should be discussed. The aim of treatment is known as obtaining a foot with normal alignment which exhibit no pain along the preventing the degenerative changes that may take place in the future. As the need of surgery is the pediatric population, the ideal subtalar joint fusion need to be extracted blood without damaging the growth plate. Gradual osmosis fits in. Operating procedure in view. The sinus starts with the foot exposed after dissection, soft tissue were excised from the tarsi. A double cortical graft harvested from the proximal tibia was placed into the small channels in the calcaneus and talus made by an osteotome, and the foot was held in flight plantiflexion and supination. The valgus level position of the heel was assessed for clinical examination intraoperatively. The graft were placed in vertical position in line with the tibia, and circular short leg cast was applied for 12 weeks until healing. This is a case of 6-year-old male patient brought to the orthopedic OPD by the baby. Chief complaint were unable to, the patient was unable to stand on feet without support till now. A deformity of both feet since birth. History of present illness, patient has a problem in standing straight over the feet, able to walk without support over the knees, but not on feet. Feet going outward on bearing weight. No any weakness in limbs, no any alteration or callosities over the feet. Persistent past history of more significant developmental milestones were reached and immunization was taken. Family history was more significant. Clinical examination, general examination, generalized ligamentous laxity with Deccan score of 9/9. Systemic examination was normal. Here you can see the laxity at the wrist joint and sign positive. Local examination, gave patient walking on knees but unable to stand straight on over the feet without support. Feet in calcaneo valgus position, plantar arch appearing on dorsiflexion of grade 2. There is no sign of spasticity, no distal vascular deficit in neurovascular deficit, no spinal effect. Summary of the case is that 6-year-old male patient with no history of prenatal distress with generalized ligamentous laxity, with no delay in milestones, with good knee balance and deformed foot, causing imbalance on bipedal stance with no spinal abnormality. Our DD is hypertonic CP, generalized ligamentous laxity with dysmorphic spinal defects. Investigation and X-ray, there was no sign of congenital vertebral talus. Fibular defects at high level, as you can see in the picture. Calcaneo valgus feet with no adaptive bony changes. The treatment given was modified gradual osmosis, that is articular subtalar osmosis. In operative procedure under general anesthesia and tourniquet control, subtalar joint was exposed, rough prepared over the talus and calcaneum. Typical graft collected from the single cortex. Graft prepared and placed between talus and calcaneum in the sinus tarsi. Patient utilized in cast for 6 weeks, started partial weight bearing after 6 weeks from ankle foot orthosis. CT scan was done before start of weight bearing. Patient was followed after 3 months, there was stable subtalar joint with tourniquet foot, the patient able to stand straight over feet. Discussion is that calcaneo valgus feet with when present in extreme deform foot, double patient is standing straight over the feet. Extractor gradual osmosis when performed properly will correct the deformity and make subtalar joint stable. This won't affect the size of the feet as spices remain undamaged. Conclusion is evaluation of the calcaneo valgus deformity and exclusion of all systemic causes or local causes and proper decision at the appropriate time will help the patient to stand over the feet with stable subtalar joint.
So you want to stabilize which joint? Subtalar articular. Right. Why do you prefer this extra-articular orthodesis named by Grayson Green in this situation?
Because this is an idiotic child. If you do the classic orthosis, then it is anterior, middle and posterior orthosis. If you should have the
What is the procedure commonly we perform to stabilize this?
Classical.
Which part of it? In order to stabilize the foot in a single sitting, which part of it is used? General.
It's
a good problem. It's a good presentation.
What is your diagnosis for this canton of Valgus foot?
We are still under, the patient is still under evaluation, sir. We actually thought of cellular dominant and Marfan syndrome. That was ruled out.
Tell us.
Ligamental
lasts. How do you make a diagnosis of the ligamental lasts?
Firstly, victim score, 9 out of 9 was there.
So how do you make that 9 points? How do you dispute that 9 points?
The bending of the thumb touches the front of the forearm, then hyperextension of the elbow, both the elbows, both the thumbs one plus thumb, both the elbows one plus thumb, then so hyperextension of the knees, both the knees one plus thumb, six and extension of the little finger more than 90 degrees, both one plus thumb, eight, touching the floor, ground, fifth hand sideways, that is one.
Did you examine all this in this
yes.
Is it normal?
All were positive.
Positive?
Yes.
Because
score was
9.9 in average. Score. That's what? When you say the patient 9.9, I was expecting which time to be? But you say the patient is stable and you have the picture of the patient. There's no hyperextension. Show me. You are thinking an answer in your picture. Think that for the time. Yes, think that. Is there a hyperextension? Okay, is there any other one? Very common type of hyperextension. Any other common condition? Like CTP. This is opposite of CTP. What's the name is from the equipment? Calcaneo matters from the correct book. You doesn't need to have all the aspect of the. Because here it doesn't look like, because we don't sustain. The most common you will have the genovita vector. That is not genovita vector. But I don't know that because we are not producing any echo. So, that's the answer. The children 6 years, sometimes it is possible to do. Because you said that the score is 9 by 9, so I was expecting some genovita vector, but it is not.
Yes,
patient went standing, you cannot prevent the automatically goes. Yes, sir.